Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to give you five more ways to use ChatGPT AI or artificial intelligence for graphic designers. And stick around till the end because there's a bonus tip, so you don't want to miss that. All right, let's get started. Now, if you missed my original five ways to use ChatGPT as a graphic designer, you can check that out. It'll be right up here in the corner of your screen. Okay, so the first way to use ChatGPT for graphic design is on your portfolio. Usually we include project descriptions, project titles, and that kind of thing. And you can have ChatGPT write those for you if you struggle with that kind of thing. Okay, so we're here at chat.openai.com. It will prompt you to log in, and you need to have a login to use this, but it's free. Okay, so I've logged in and I'm going to input this prompt, and you'll be able to find this in the description under the video. Acting as a graphic designer portfolio creator, write a 100-word max blurb about a portfolio project. And then I put in the details of a specific portfolio project, what the name of it was, kind of a description of what it was all about, what collateral was created for it, and also the programs that I used. So I'll go ahead and enter that. And here's what ChatGPT has come up with. Introducing Mom in the City, a captivating portfolio project tailored for moms and moms-to-be in the vibrant New Jersey area. And then it goes on to explain the event collateral, and then it talks about the programs, and it already knows what Illustrator, InDesign, and Photoshop are and what they do. So this is actually way better than the one I have currently in my portfolio. So it's just a matter of copying and pasting this. And there are some things I would change. I wouldn't really say that my own portfolio project is captivating, for example. So I might take this out. I might even take out portfolio because obviously this is a portfolio project. So I don't think it needs to be said, but I think it did a really great job. Now I can also modify this. So let's say I really want to include something about the target audience. I'll just say, add the target audience to the blurb, and it'll rewrite it, including some text about the target audience, which when I was testing this, it did a better job. That's something that you'll have to play around with ChatGPT. The fact that sometimes it'll give you really great specific information, and then sometimes it'll do stuff like this, and you'll just have to let it know that that's not what you're looking for. So maybe I can say, what is the target audience for this project? And we'll see if it comes up with something similar to what I was given when I made the project. Okay, so I asked it for age, and now it did a little better. So maybe I can include some of this verbiage in my blurb. And maybe we could just modify this to whatever the real ages were that were given to us when we made this project. Here's a little kind of extra bonus tip. If you're in college or you're just graduating college and your portfolio is filled with projects that are using dummy text like lorem ipsum or other placeholder text, you can get ChatGPT to write seemingly real copy for all of your projects. So I'm basically asking ChatGPT to write content for a 3-panel brochure. That would be 6 panels if you count both front and back. It's going to be a travel brochure about Sri Lanka. I want some paragraphs and some bullet points. Okay, and here is the content that it's given us. On the front, we just have a title, which is normally the most text you'll see on a cover. Usually there's like a little logo, but it's usually just the title. Panel 2, I think it did really good with the amount of content, and we might want to cut this down a little bit. Might be a little long for panel 2. Now it says back panel and then didn't give us anything. And I'm not sure what it's doing with panel 3. Maybe it wants us to fill that with an image and just have the title on the interior's left side panel. Then for panel 4, we have quite a bit of content. You can always ask ChatGPT to write this in less words. And then it does go ahead and like list out panel 5 and panel 6, which I probably should have just told it to do 5 panels because usually your back panel is just links and your address and phone number and that kind of thing. It did a really great job, especially since this is just filler text to replace your lorem ipsum. The second way to use ChatGPT is for blog posts. A lot of us as graphic designers will have a blog along with our portfolio website. And the reason we do this is just to kind of show employers that we care about graphic design and trends and that kind of thing. Or you might even have a standalone graphic design blog. But if you've ever written a blog, you know how much time and research goes into writing every single blog post. Now ChatGPT can pretty much do all of the research for you. You're going to want to check to make sure, you know, it's correct and that kind of thing. But this can be a huge time saver. So let's look at a prompt for this. For our blog posts, we want 500 words about font choice and typography and their importance. We also want it to be conversational. Sometimes ChatGPT can kind of read like a textbook, so you can change the tone. You can even put in a sample of your own writing and say, hey, make it the same style. Let's see what it comes up with. So it's written all of this text. I'm just going to go over here to my word counter and see how many words it wrote. It wrote 497 words, which is pretty good. Sometimes it'll go with way less and you just need to kind of check how many words it actually writes. But I think it did a really great job with this. You definitely want to go in and edit it and check any facts that they're saying are true, because ChatGPT tends to make stuff up sometimes. The third way to use it is for freelancers, especially if you're using social media content to promote yourself. Here are a few prompts for you. Acting as a content creator, create a 30-day social media calendar for Facebook posts. Your client is a freelance graphic designer. And then it will give us 30 days worth of social media ideas. So this is great for someone like me who really struggles with coming up with, you know, unique content for every single day. And, you know, that's why I don't do it. But when it's laid out like this, it makes it easy. So here's the next month's social media posts. So now we can take this one step further. I'm going to copy the day two idea, and then I'll paste in this prompt. Write specific content for this Facebook post, and then I've pasted in that second one. So here is an example Facebook post showcasing a recent design project. And so you could take this text, you could just modify to match the real design you made, and just basically use it as a template. Now, if you're a graphic designer whose job includes web design, which a lot of graphic designers have that responsibility, you can use ChatGPT to help you write code. From what I hear, it can write pretty complex code, but here's a simple example for you. Write HTML5 code for a Thank God It's Friday GIF. And so it gives us a document with HTML tags, heading tags, body, and that kind of thing. And you can just copy the code right up here. And it even gives you instructions on what to do. You would take your own GIF and put it here with its path. And then you could also save this code as an HTML file using a text editor and then open it in a web browser. So it's very simple, but you know, it can do way more than just this. And then finally, the fifth thing that ChatGPT can do to make our jobs easier is to help us write emails. Okay, for this prompt, I'm just basically going to ask it to respond to this email that I got from my boss. The email says, hey, I wanted to check in on this project. Okay, and here is what ChatGPT came up with. It's pretty lengthy. I think my boss would not like this type of answer. And also it's using kind of strange words like, I appreciate your proactive approach and willingness to support me. I don't think my boss would like that at all. So I'm going to say, keep it short and conversational. So it did really good this time with those two requests. Just wanted to give you a quick update. Everything's going well. I'm making good progress. And I don't need anything else from you, but I'll reach out if I do. So this is definitely something usable. Now you can also input text and have ChatGPT correct your grammar. So if you want to use your own words, but you're not great at writing, or maybe you struggle with spelling, you can input text and have ChatGPT correct it. So in that case, I would just put correct the grammar, then a colon, and then the text you wanted it to correct. Bonus tip. If your company uses freelancers or has coworkers in other countries, you can use ChatGPT to write emails to them in their language. ChatGPT works really well translating other languages in a conversational way. I actually tested this and wrote a message to my Japanese friend using ChatGPT, and she said the Japanese was absolutely flawless. Now, if you're worried about some idioms and making sure that they're translated correctly, you can always check this in Google Translate and see how it comes out. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you!